A quick summary, we have seen three different interpretations of PCA, and eigenvectors played a very crucial role in that. And the other thing which played a crucial role was the covariance matrix of the original data. And with these three different interpretations, what we realized is that the solution that we get, or the transformed data that we get by projecting the original data onto a basis consisting of the eigenvectors, ensures that there is high variance across the new dimensions, and we can ignore of the bottom n minus k dimensions along which the variance is not high. This also ensures that the error in reconstructing the data by ignoring these dimensions is minimized, right? It's the lowest possible error. And it also ensures that the covariance between your retained dimensions is zero, because we are able to diagonalize the covariance matrix of the transformed data, right? So that's what we have. So now, if you think of it, right, so this is just to connect it to things that we'll need later on for autoencoders, that we're trying to learn a new representation for the data, right? And we are trying to also compress the data. And we want this compression to be such that it's as lossless as possible, right? We are going from n dimensions to k dimensions, and still we want to retain the essence of the data and don't want to lose out on much of the information in the data. Okay, so that's essentially what PCA is doing. Now let's see this in practice.